Stella's work has been in the area of helping work with the public education systems, trying to get their quality to get better. In the area of early childhood education particularly, as Rashda said, we are talking not just of improving a system so that it can serve these children better, which of course it will if it does get better, whether it's through communities and parents or through the center-based works at the Anganwadis, etc., etc. But we're also talking about working with a system which works with the underprivileged, those whose voices are not heard particularly well in our society, those whose opportunities for contributing to the society have been systematically denied over a long period of time. So doing that work today and helping those children get better inputs, that all the stuff that you heard a short while ago, makes it possible not only for those children to have better lives, but also to change the face of the society 30, 40, 50 years from now. It makes it possible for a whole new set of people to come into the conversation, a whole new set of people whose voices have not been heard to be heard in the future. So we think it's not just a matter of doing good education, it's a matter of changing the entire complexion of the society, which is why we seek most of our work is to work with the government systems which provide such services, and in this case ICDS primarily, but also communities and so on, to learn how to deliver better early childhood education and development. So my conversation today is primarily about how we do that, rather than what Rashda has already done, which is why is it important? You've heard that. So as you probably, all of you know, we adopted an ECC policy in 2013 after, I think, 3 decades of lobbying by people who saw the importance of it. 1970, mid-70s, when the ICDS scheme was introduced, early childhood development and education was a critical and fundamental part of it, and yet nothing happened. I can't say a whole lot is happening even now, unfortunately, but at least we have a policy, and at least we have people who are actually seriously invested in it. So in spite of the policy being there, we must acknowledge, and in spite of ICDS having ECC, in spite of having ECCE as a critical part of the overall ICDS mandate, sachai ye hai ke ICDS ke liye ECC naya hai. They don't know how to do it. It's the reality. And therefore, jo kuch kaam hum karte hain, wo ye assumption leke ke shuru se shuru karna hai. So, if we think about what is required, therefore, at a systemic level, it's easy for someone to say, "Anganwadi mein chale gaye, to aisa 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 kar sakte hain. Anganwadi worker ko sikha diya, to wo kar le." Lekin desh bhar mein 15 lakh anganwadi hain. 15 lakh anganwadiyon mein ye sab hona chahiye, tab jaake jo Bharat ke jitne bachche hain, jo 50-60% bachche jo anganwadi mein jaate hain, unko sahi inputs mil payenge. तो ये केवल एक आंगनवाड़ी वर्कर को जाके सिखाने का सवाल नहीं है, ये सवाल है कि ये सिस्टम किस तरह से सीखे कि इस काम को कैसे करना चाहिए. तो कई चीजें हैं, पॉलिसी गोल्स क्या हैं, उनको इंप्लीमेंट कैसे करना चाहिए, प्लानिंग कैसे करनी चाहिए, टेक्निकल एक्सपर्टीज कैसे बने, न सिर्फ आंगनवाड़ी वर्कर में बल्कि स्टेट लेवल के ऑफिशियल्स में, डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल के ऑफिशियल्स में, ब्लॉक लेवल के ऑफिशियल्स में, क्योंकि सपोर्ट तो उन्हीं को करना है. इंटरनल मॉनिटरिंग, सपोर्टिव सुपरविजन, इस सब का कल्चर कैसे बनेगा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में ताकि ये काम अच्छी तरह से हो सके. रिजल्ट्स कैसे देखेंगे, ठीक हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है, कट किए जा रहे हैं लेकिन काम उसका फायदा हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है, इसको कैसे करेंगे. तो दीज आर वेरियस एंड ऑफ कोर्स द फंडामेंटल क्वेश्चन ऑफ हाउ डू यू प्रोवाइड लीडरशिप, हाउ डू यू मोटिवेट पीपल. एवरीवन इफ यू टॉक टू एनीवन दे विल से हमारे यहाँ लोग काम नहीं करते. तो अच्छा भाई, लेकिन आपने क्या किया उसको ठीक करने के लिए, इसका जवाब बहुत कम मिलता है. अच्छा जवाब बहुत कम मिलता है. तो ये चैलेंजेस हैं इफेक्टिव ईसीसी करने के लिए. अब अगर ये माने कि इसके लिए कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग की जरूरत है, और आमतौर पर क्या कहते हैं, क्या वो 15 लाख आंगनवाड़ी वर्कर्स हैं, उन सब की कैपेसिटी बढ़ा दो. कैसे बढ़ाएंगे, उनको एक ट्रेनिंग करा दो, वो काम हो जाएगा. बहुत किया है आंगनवाड़ी वर्कर्स की ट्रेनिंग की है, स्कूल टीचर्स की ट्रेनिंग की है, किसकी की ट्रेनिंग की है, सब लोग थक गए. अब मुझे भाई ट्रेनिंग से बताओ अब क्या करना है. तो when we look at the question of what ails the system, we recognize that it is true that the frontline functionaries do not have the capacity, whether it's the Anganwadi worker or the school teacher or the community worker, etc. They don't have the capacity to help create conditions in which young children can receive all the inputs and and support that they require. But that's not the cause of the problem. The cause of the problem is that we have a system which does not create conditions, which does not have the leadership to create conditions for that to happen. If you go to any state, and I have done this in at least 10 or 15 states by now, if I go and ask the senior most bureaucrats the question of who's responsible for quality in your system, you'll never find one. Nowhere will you find, in no state have I seen, one person saying, this person actually takes charge of quality. Not bad. Hum log training karte hain. There is one person who will say, training karte hain. There is another person who will say, hum log materials banate hain. There is another person who will say, hum administration karte hain. Quality ke liye kaun banda hai? Koi nahi. So, leadership is a critical challenge. Leadership, an integrated leadership, is a critical challenge that exists, which in our opinion is the cause of the difficulties. And therefore, what we have worked on, what we have looked at, is the approach which says we must build leadership across the entire hierarchy of the implementing organizations, whether it's ICDS or education or whatever. Let's go back a little bit. And we see three key areas that need to be addressed in, as far as that's concerned. For the development of the leadership. One is, and this is most fundamental in some sense, in our view, there is a need for role redefinition. Hum kaun hain? Agar DPO hai, ya CDPO hai, ya district education officer hai, who am I for this? What is my role in making this happen? Most of them, if you look into their heads, they think of themselves as administrators. Leave, sign karo, office approve karo. Wo sab itna bar ho raha hai, sab log apne apne office mein aa rahe hain, to kaam ho raha hai. A role redefinition which says there is meaning to our work, there is a significance to our work. It changes society, makes things happen, and we have the ability and the agency to do it, is the key lacuna that exists at the moment, which needs to be filled. And of course you need, along with that, skill acquisition. What does it mean to do good early childhood education, for instance? What does it mean to provide good quality support for a child? What does it mean to take into account the developments of cognitive sciences, to design programs and implement them effectively, etc.? Skill acquisition. And most importantly, developing a sense of agency. I think one of the most difficult things that most government systems face is the feeling that we can do nothing. Hamare haath mein kuch nahi hai, upar se chitthi aayegi to hum kuch kar payenge. When you change that and you see, help people see what they can do on their own within the limitations that they face, I think some very, very interesting magic starts to happen. There's a lot of stuff here. I'm not going to go through that because I've been shown some some placards. I'm just going to run through this very quickly. What we have done is we basically said we'll take this idea to large-scale systems so that the state governments can learn how to do this well over a period of time. So we've implemented what we call an ICDS leadership program, which is designed as with all these what I said earlier, take the entire hierarchy of ICDS in those states. They're not done across states. They're not done in selected districts. In Chhattisgarh, we do it in 5 districts. In UP, we've done it in about 5 districts. In Bihar, we are doing it in 2 districts, and in Goa, in the entire state. How do you take this entire structure, starting from the DPO all the way down to the Anganwadi worker, and help them become learners? Each one of them, not just some people, not just one corner in somewhere, but the entire organization becomes engaged in the process of learning and teaching. So we will work with, let's say, DPOs or CDPOs, who will then be expected to work with their people, who will then be expected to work with their people until it reaches the Anganwadi worker. And we have created several processes which we think has, to some extent, addressed the major question of cascade loss in these processes. We've created a whole new approach which we call the mindful cascade, which essentially takes into account the fact that people need to be mindful of what they're doing in order for that process to go all the way. One of these days, when they have a little more time, I can tell you a little more about the details of that. But we've had, fortunately, and we are very gratified, we had good results of that, which suggests that that's a technology that actually seems to work and avoids the most challenging shortcomings of long cascades. These are all programs in Chhattisgarh and Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, have been supported by UNICEF. Goa, we are still working on developing it. The other thing that we do is what we call caregiver coaching for nurturing care. Rashida talked about nurturing care framework. We've been working on this for the last about 7 years now. We've been working in parent education for a much longer period of time as an organization. But this particular approach, what we call CCNC, the Caregiver Coaching for Nurturing Care, we started in Chhattisgarh in 2012. The basic idea is working with parents primarily, but also with communities somewhat. And I think one of the interesting things we are trying to, at this time, assess, evaluate, is what is the quality of diffusion that happens when you work only with parents? What is the quality of diffusion that happens to the rest of the community? And to what extent does it create what you would call efficient ways of engaging the entire community? What do you say to the parents in order that not only do they work with their own children, but also become ambassadors of that whole idea to the rest of the community, and so on. I think there are basically 2 or 3 different things that we have done there. The most long-running has been the one that we currently done in Rajnandgaon in Chhattisgarh, which is where we started first, and that is still continuing, but it's a small-scale program. That small-scale program has had very interesting successes, including, very surprisingly for us, even though when we started the program, we said what we are looking for is stimulation, social-emotional development, psychosocial development, et cetera, all of that, all of those kind of inputs. And we found, as we could have known, because there's a lot of research on that, extant research, but most people in India hadn't paid attention to it. We found that a lot of children in that group where we were working improved their nutritional status dramatically. They went from being severely undernourished to being moderately undernourished, or from being moderately undernourished to being normal, and so on and so forth. Lots of them. Which caught the attention of the government then, and we then went, as the governments are prone to do, large scale, whole scale, whole state. So we actually ended up working with the Mitanin, which is the community health worker garden there, elsewhere in India called Asha. And we created a program for them where about 60,000 Mitanins were trained. It needs much more work. But we've done something. It's been integrated into the workbooks and the consciousness of the Mitanins in the state, that their work is not limited only to immunization and delivery, but there's a whole lot of other stuff that the parents can be engaged with, and which parents find very, very useful. I think that the nice thing for Mitanins in the state, and there are, as I said, there are 60,000 of them, has been that they have discovered a new meaning in their work. One of the most common responses that we've had from Mitanins is, "Bahut bore ho gaye the, wahi karte karte karte. Ab kuch naya karne ko mil raha hai aur logon ko bahut acha lag raha hai, parents ko bahut acha lag raha hai, kaisa ho raha hai." So we are really excited about the work that we're doing. Again, there's a lot of details about this program, another time perhaps. So both ILP and CCNC engage the entire set of government functionaries in the target intervention. This is one of our basic principles. We prefer not to do things in a corner as much as possible, because we realize that governments are not excited by that. If you go to meet a secretary, he wants to do it over the whole state. If you go to meet a district collector, he wants to do it over the whole district. And if you do it in a small place, he's not interested. You can do whatever you want, but he will not put his weight behind it. So we try as much as possible to take it to as large a scale as possible without losing the key quality parameters that we hope will work. And as I said, the intervention concepts are tailored to capacity building for building capacity. We are asking the government systems to develop the capacity to build their own capacity, because we don't think it's sustainable for them to depend on external organizations forever, or for even too longer time, even a relatively short period of time. So our work is always aimed at how do we build the capacity of this system to build its own capacity on an ongoing basis, so that essentially we can make ourselves irrelevant as quickly as possible. And our engagement is for the system to engage with what we call pedagogical leadership. If you're helping children learn, you better know what learning means and how it works and what happens when children learn and what is good learning and what is not good learning and so on and so forth. Institutional leadership, the people who run those systems need to know how to inspire, motivate, manage, plan, monitor, all of this. These are critical institutional leadership functions which need to be learned. We help them to do that. And community leadership, if they're not engaging with the community, their work is half done. So these three areas are what, for both CCNC and ILP, we embed into the design. And of course, both of them then create long-term resource group within the systems. I think we'll just go through this quickly. I just want to go back to this is a story about how these programs work and why the cascades work, why they don't lose as much as normal cascades normally do, et cetera, et cetera. But I think I just want to take this last thing. No, just go back. Forward, please. Yeah. So I just want to sort of talk about these two kinds of programs. The ICDS leadership program, which is essentially, it says ICDS has to transform itself. We are not saying we'll train people. We're saying ICDS needs to learn to transform itself to a learning organization, and we will help you to create processes and motivations to do that, to become a learning organization where every level is engaged in learning and teaching. And it's, we think that's what makes it sustainable. As I said, we want to become irrelevant as quickly as we possibly can by creating a set of resources within the organization. And we think it's reasonably innovative. It's been tried for the first time really in this way and in this scale at this in the government. We certainly hope that it's a capacity building technology that will take hold, because we think that it's one of the few ways in which large scale capacity building can happen relatively quickly. And CCNC, on the other hand, we worked 60,000 Mithanins large scale, but within significant constraints on their own ability to follow the long-term process. And we have seen that in the process, it will require substantial additional work, so that what we want Mithanins to develop into is coaches and counselors for parents. Right now, they are more broadcast agents. They have learned something, they're able to talk to parents about that, parents accept it. To the extent that they accept it, there is good happening on the ground. But parents have questions, they come back with challenges and problems. We haven't yet helped the Mithanins to develop a deep enough understanding of all of that in order to be able to respond effectively. That's the next stage in CCNC, in Chhattisgarh at least, for us. And ultimately the purpose, I think Mithanin in Chhattisgarh means Sukh Dukh Ki Saathi. And really that's what we want them to become in due course. Not just in Chhattisgarh, of course, but elsewhere where such a program can go. And I think that's what they need to become, so that they can have the traction and the space in the lives of the parents, the communities, to be able to make a difference. So that's our next challenge. Thank you.